Dear friends, welcome to the video content on diversity in living organisms number 3, animal classification. In this content, we will learn about following topics: introduction to kingdom Animalia, criteria for classification of animals, classification of animals. Introduction. We will begin this lesson with understanding about kingdom Animalia in detail. Kingdom Animalia. There are unlimited varieties of living organisms in the nature, showing numerous diverse characteristics in their body structure, function and habit. Due to the effect of evolutionary process, unicellular organisms have become multicellular animals. Animals belonging to kingdom Animalia are eukaryotic and multicellular, having heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Cells of these animals do not possess cell wall. Most of these animals are mobile and possess locomotory organ, that is, except sponges. These animals can be free living parasites or may live symbiotically with other organisms. Criteria for animal classification. Now we will understand what is the basis and criteria considered for animal classification. Kingdom Animalia includes millions of diverse organisms. Some of the important basic criteria considered for the classification for animals are as described below. The body structure, body design, and cellular composition of the animal is one of the important bases considered for classification. Another criteria for animal classification is the complexity of the body organization of the animal. Presence or absence of notochord in the animal is also an important factor considered for classification of animals. Presence and absence of body cavity and type of body cavities present in the animal. Categories of classification. On the basis of presence or absence of notochord, kingdom Animalia is divided into following two main groups. Number 1, non-chordate, that is, invertebrate, do not possess notochord. Number 2, chordata, that is, possesses notochord. Non-chordate and chordate animals are further divided into different groups on the basis of different characteristics based on body structure, body cavity, tissue organization, and cellular organization, etc. Categories of classification. Non-chordate animals are further divided into following groups. Number 1, Porifera. 2, Coelenterata. 3, Platyhelminthes. 4, Nematoda. 5, Annelida. 6, Anthropoda. 7, Mollusca. And 8, Echinodermata. Chordate animals are further divided into two following groups. Number 1, Protochordata. Number 2, Vertebrata. Vertebrates are further divided into following groups. Number 1, Pisces. Number 2, Amphibia. Number 3, Reptilia. Number 4, Aves. And number 5, Mammalia. Phylum Porifera. Phylum Porifera includes simplest multicellular marine animals known as sponges. These are non-motile animals which are attached to some solid support. These animals have holes or canal system in their body to help in water circulation throughout the body for food and oxygen transport. These animals possess hard outer skeletal layer. Most sponges are asymmetrical in shape, having porous body with a single large opening called osculum. Reproduction in these animals is both asexual as well as sexual. The images shown in here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this phylum. Examples for phylum Porifera are Spongilia, Euplectella, and Cycon. Phylum Coelenterata. Animals of this phylum possesses body which has radical symmetry and also show presence of body activity. These animals are aquatic and may be living in colonies or live solitary. Their body is made up of two layers of cell. One layer present outside the body and other forms inner lining of the body. Animals possess tentacles which have special sting cells called cnidoblasts. Reproduction in these animals is usually asexual but can be as sexual as in medusae form. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this phylum. For example, jellyfish and hydra, that is sea anemones. Phylum Platyhelminthes, that is flatworms. Animal's body possesses bilateral symmetry and body cavity absent. Animals have three layers of cell from which differentiated tissues can be formed, hence these are known as triploblastic. They are mostly parasitic, but some may be free living. Body is dorsoventrally flattened, hence are known as flatworms. These are mostly hermaphrodite. These images shown here illustrate the examples of some animals included in this phylum. For example, Planaria, Fasciola, that is liverfly, Tanea solium, and T. emplumada, that is tapeworm. Phylum Nematoda or round worm. These animals are small cylindrical or round worms which are parasites. Their body cavity is not true coelom, but a pseudocoelom is present. They have complete and straight alimentary canal. Their body is bilateral, symmetrical and triploblastic. Both sexes are separate in these animals. The image shown here illustrates the example of these animals included in this phylum. For example, Ascaris, that is roundworm, Ancylostoma, that is hookworm, Wuschereria, that is filarial worm which causes elephantiasis. Phylum Annelida. These animals have elongated and segmented body having true coelom, that is body cavity. They are found in the variety of habitats. Their body bears lateral appendages for locomotion with the help of parapodia, that is setae, and the body is bilateral, symmetrical and triploblastic. These animals have sexual mode of reproduction and both sexes may be separate or they can be hermaphrodite. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this phylum. For example, Ferretima, that is earthworm, and Hirudinaria, cattle leech, and Nereis. Phylum Arthropoda. This phylum contains the largest group of animals. These animals have jointed legs or appendages and compounded eyes on the head. Their body is segmented, which can be divided into three regions: viscerate, head, thorax, and abdomen. And the body has chitinous exoskeleton. The body cavity is known as hemocoel, which is filled with blood and have open circulatory system. Animals are bilaterally symmetrical. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this phylum. For example, scorpion, spider, butterfly, apis, that is honeybee, musca, that is housefly. Phylum Mollusca. These are mostly aquatic animals having non-segmented, soft, bilateral, symmetrical body which can be divided into head, dorsal, visceral, mass, central foot. Their coelomic cavity is reduced. These animals have open circulatory system and kidney-like organs for excretion. Some animals have hard calcareous shell as outer body coverings. Respiration in these animals is by gills called tenidia. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this phylum. For example, Pila, that is snail, Unio, that is freshwater mussel, octopus and chiton. Phylum Echinodermata. These marine free-living animals are triploblastic. They have coelomic cavity which is modified into water vascular system which is connected with tube feet for locomotion. The body surface is covered all over by calcareous spines. Sexes in these animals are separate. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this phylum. For example, Asterias, that is starfish, Echinus, that is sea urchins, Entodon, that is feather star. Phylum Protocordata. These are marine triploblastic free living animals. They have bilateral symmetry and coelom present. They have long rod like structure running along the back of animal called notochord, which presents at the same stage of life. It provides support for attachment. The image shown here illustrates the example of animal included in this phylum. For examples, Balanglocus, Herdemania and Amphioxus. Phylum Vertebrata, that is Chordates. Vertebrates have bilateral symmetrical body, coelom and are triploblastic. They have true vertebral column, internal skeleton and dorsal nerve cord. Respiration in these animals is through lungs in terrestrial vertebrates and through gills in aquatic animals. These animals are further divided into five groups: Pisces, Amphibia, Reptilia, Aves and Mammalia. Class Pisces. These are fish and other aquatic animals. Skin of these animals is covered with scales or plates. They possess fins but limbs are absent. Animals are cold-blooded and heart has two chambers. They lay eggs. Some fish have skeleton made up of cartilage, cartilaginous fish, while some have skeleton made up of bones and cartilages both, that is bony fish. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this class. For example, sharks, stingray, dogfish, lionfish, katla, and hilsa. Class Amphibia. These animals can live both in water and on the land, hence the name amphibians. These animals are cold-blooded and their heart has three chambers. They possess mucus gland in the skin without scales. Respiration in these animals is through lungs or gills. They lay eggs in water. The body can be divided into distant head and trunk, but neck and tail may be absent. Possess four limbs which are pentadactyle type, that is five-fingered. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this class. For example, salamander, frog, that is Rana tigrina, and Nectarus hyla. Class Reptilia, that is creeping vertebrates. These are mostly terrestrial animals living in warm climates. Their body is covered with scales and it shows variation in form. It can be divided into distinct head, neck and trunk regions. These animals possesses two pairs of pentadactyle limbs, except snakes and some lizards. These are cold-blooded animals having heart with three chambers, except crocodile which has four-chambered heart. Respiration in this animal is by lungs. They lay eggs having hard covering. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this class. For example, chameleon, crocodile, flying lizard, that is Draco, and snakes. Class Aves, that is birds. This class includes all birds having two forelimbs modified into wings for flight. Exoskeleton of these animals has bones with air cavities. Their body is covered with feathers. The body can be divided into head, neck, trunk, and tail. They are warm-blooded animals with four-chambered heart. They lay eggs which are made up of hard shell. Jaws in the mouth of these animals is in the form of modified beak, which is used for different purposes. Respiration is through lungs. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this class. Examples: pigeon, that is Columba, ostrich, struthio, sparrow, P. domesticus, and crow, C. Brachii rhynchos. Class Mammalia. Mammals have body of varied shape, size, and is covered with hair and have sweat and oil glands. They possess mammary glands for production of milk to nourish young offsprings. Most mammals produce young offsprings, hence they are called viviparous, except platypus and echidna, which lay eggs. Respiration in these animals is through lungs. They are warm-blooded animals having four-chambered heart. They possess two pairs of pentadactyle limbs for various purposes. Their eyes are covered with movable lids and ears external. The images shown here illustrate the examples of some of animals included in this class. For example, lion, tiger, rat, monkey, chimpanzee, and humans. Test yourself. These are few questions for you. Please revise the concept by solving them on your own. Thank you. This content was developed under Akash School Project. This project is funded by NME ICT and MHRD Government of India. If you wish to contact us, please mail us at the given email ID. Thank you for watching this content.